Well, howdy everybody, it's Fisherman Rich, and yes, we are with the RV down here in wonderful, sunny Sanford, Florida.
We're going to probably meander over to Gemini Springs a little bit later,
adventuring into someplace new.
So, man, we got ants all over us. What in the world's going on? Can't I just record anything without a dang blasted ant?
Down the trail, where are the fish here? So let's get back to fishing, because I'm doing the talking and they're doing the swimming. We got it. Yes, we did. Everybody, have a swim. Woo!
There we go. Yeah!
This batch of meat.
Oh, dang, blast it.
We be making memories.
He's a big one. We got another pet fish. Ow, he bit me!
And still, nothing was really biting at all.
Yes, I've been here many times in the past, but never really fishing it. But we is armed and dangerous. One thing you gotta be careful of is the bike riders. They come zinging through here up at this trailhead, so you definitely want to be minding the trail all the way back to the fishing spot.
I've never seen anybody with an air pump on a kayak. That's pretty interesting.
And there goes the young man with the paddleboard. You blow up. He's going down the water to put himself in for a while. Said he'll be a subscriber now. We will see.
Let's get the show on the road. No, he's not. We didn't betray the old Mini. We just in the other vehicle we own. Okay, let's lock it. We're surprised that the wife is letting us drive it on this fishing adventure. Now, I think it's a long walk down there to the fishing pier. Well, we's almost there, and we did cancel that gym membership because we weren't using it because we was fishing so much, and that's where we got all the exercise. But you know, Fisherman Rich, he's got to take it all with him all the time, so we's not too bad out of breath. Looks like we got a couple people fishing up here already. Oh boy, look at that. Fish from pier only, no cast nets. Two poles, we's in trouble right there. So I guess we's gonna have to just put up the other three we brought.
Who's catching all the fish here? Good morning. Guess I'm at a two pole minimum here, not the five I brought. Oh, look at that water, it is so nice and clear, and there's fishy swimming all around in it. Let's see if we can entice them with some food that we brought.
Okay, we're gonna toss this one out and see how well he does. We've seen some 5-pound bass just swimming right around in here. Yeah, you can only be fishing from the pier, but the water's so clear you can actually see your bait down there. Yes, Fisherman Rich has not been bested by this spot. We just put a night crawler out there, actually a red wiggly on the bottom, and just let it sit there with a split shot, and we caught one. One guy, he already left, and I don't blame him. If you want to catch some nice sights and sounds, this is the place to be. But a lot of fish are on their nest, and let's put this guy out here live. Yeah, you can probably see him. A bass came up to my little bluegill down there and just passed him by, but he's attracting all sorts of wonderful attention. The only thing I'll be catching over here is a bunch of bluegill. Yes, we got a fishy on, just a small guy. We're going to have to trade his hind parts out for the dead one. Oh, yeah, let's see if we can get that big old bass that's been underneath there to come out after his guy. Looks like somebody else knows that this is a good fishing spot right here, because they're kind of hoarding in on where I'm at.
It's a fishing duel.
this young man has stepped into Fisherman Rich's territory. So it's a duel who can catch the first fish here. He's had to rebait a couple times or reload. And I ain't caught another one yet. Well, it looks like we got a fish from right down yonder. The fishing duel is on. We caught a baby bluegill, but he's a good fun size for bait. All right, young man, it's your turn for the fishing duel in this spot, so let's see how well you do. He did catch a fish. Oh, yes, he did. We got a nice little sunfish down there. Yes, we do. Let's hoist him up, get him up. Not a bad size one right there. Trying to elude Fisherman Rich, but we got him, by golly. Now it's his turn to catch the fish. And he caught a fish, too. Look what this young man is doing right here. He has given me all this stuff. He's going back to New York tomorrow. And look at all that. Wow.
He's got the D-hooks.
Look at that. Now, that is a true fisherman right there. Can't believe it. Thank you, sir.
I'm about to give it to somebody, then throw it away, you know?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, definitely. Thank you so much. Appreciate that. All right, the local right here, he gave me a hot dog. Yes, he did, for the channel. So he said this is the secret bait. This is proof that the hot dog works in this here spot really well. So if you come to Gemini Springs, this here be the spot to catch some bluegills at least, because on the other side, you got a bunch of tilapia on their nests. You got big fish swimming through, but they just ain't biting on anything. Well, we caught a couple bluegill, saw a bunch of big bass, but in retrospect, we had a good time. Met a couple people, remarkable people, people that just have a heart to give. And we just thank that feller for giving us all that wonderful stuff, and we wish him a good trip back to New York City. But one thing about the area, if you get a chance on a nice hot day, this is a plug for Andy's. Let's see, we get it in there. Andy's Frozen Custard. The wife and I, we stopped by and we had a Rico Suave, and boy, it was dad burn good. So I encourage you to go, because there's only like two in Orlando, none in Jacksonville. So that's just a little plug for Andy's. And we will be seeing you on the next episode. Thanks for joining. Well, as always, there's going to be a fish in the fishing video, because it has to qualify as one to be a video that has fish in it.